The movie Gettysburg came out in 1993. It was a miniseries originally, and Ted Turner bought it, made it into a full-length movie. It's one of the longest movies ever written. It's 2 hours and 54 minutes. It was not a box office hit. It was directed by Robert Maxwell. It was an incredible movie and powerful. I mean, the subject matter is so powerful, and the movie was powerful. So Randy Edelman was charged with the task of writing the music to this movie. Music can convey and portray things about a situation that nothing else can. The power, the emotion, the feelings that come with it. But how do you compose a movie score to a battle that's the bloodiest battle that ever took place in our country, that 7,000 people died, 35,000 people were injured, and everybody that died were our people. They were all our residents of the same country. 5,000 horses died. This poor city, which was not much of anything until this battle, had the stench of 5,000 carcasses burning, hanging over their city for days and trying to bury the dead. It was a tremendous task to write the movie music to this, and I think he did a brilliant job. There are four main themes, and they're all in major, and there's still this ominous tone cluster that reappears now and then. How do you write triumphal music because you won when you lost so much? And I think he did it beautifully. This is arranged by Pete Strohm, who's in our audience tonight, who came all the way from Washington State to hear this, and it's beautifully arranged. And I'll recognize him at the end. The movements are, there's a prologue, and then it's January 1, 2, and 3 of 1863. I mean, we know when this happened, and the movie music is designated day one, day two, day three. Day one talks about the four generals, two Confederate, two Union. Day two is some places that were prominent in the war. Peachtree Orchard, Devil's Den. These were places in that town that could be like Highland Park or High Falls. I mean, it could be anywhere. They just happened to be there when this battle was taking place. The third day is Pickett's Charge. Pickett was a Confederate general, and it was not a successful charge. And the music is incredibly triumphant because we won, but there were huge amounts of casualty that day. And then he goes right into an epilogue, which I think has a lot to say about it. It's hard to just, I've had to put this whole thing in perspective in preparing the score. Lincoln didn't do the address until the following November, and 272 words made the most powerful speech maybe in our history, talking about this battle. So this music had to be very profound and very powerful. I think the combination of Randy Edelman's beautiful score and Pete Strom's arrangement really achieves that. So this is the music from the movie Gettysburg.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.